Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the Web Application Penetration Testing and Secure Coding. As per your demand, I'm making a video on how to install Kali Linux on VirtualBox. So let's get started. Let's first look at what is a virtualization. Virtualization means we can create a new virtual environment in our laptop or a desktop. In the virtualization, we split the computer resources to host the virtual systems. Virtualization softwares are known as a hypervisor. There are different products available such as VirtualBox, VMware, Hyper-V, Xen, etc. For this course, we are going to use VirtualBox. Let's look at how virtualization or hypervisor works. First, there is your hardware. That means it is your desktop or a laptop. On that, there is your base operating system. It can be Windows, Mac or Linux. Now what we do, we install hypervisor such as a VirtualBox or VMware, and with the help of our hypervisor we can install one OS on top of another OS. We can install Ubuntu or we can install any version of a Windows, and as in this course we are going to install a Kali Linux. So this is how virtualization works. This is known as your host OS or a base OS, and on top of that you install another OS known as the guest OS. So on your host OS, you can install multiple guest OS. Let's look at the virtualization advantages. Now just imagine you have a 500 GB of hard disk, 16 GB of RAM and 4 CPU cores in your desktop or a laptop. So what we will do, we will give the 50 GB of hard disk, 1 GB of RAM and 1 CPU core to the Ubuntu. For a Windows, we can give 100 GB of hard disk, 2 GB of RAM and 1 CPU core. And for Kali Linux, we are giving 80 GB of hard disk, 2 GB of RAM and 1 CPU core. So this is how we can divide available physical resources for the virtual machines. With the virtualization, we can use more services with less physical hardware, because as we know, the physical hardware is very expensive. The advantage of virtualization is snapshot and restore. That means with the snapshot, we are saving the state of that virtual machine. And if something goes wrong in the future, we can restore that snapshot and we can start using that virtual machine from that safe state. So this is the best thing about the virtualization. For this course, we are going to use VirtualBox because it's completely free. VirtualBox is developed by Oracle Group. To download the VirtualBox, go to the virtualbox.org, then click on Downloads. If your base OS is Windows, then download this. And if your base OS is OS X, then download this. After downloading VirtualBox, just simply install it. As you can see, this is how it will look. Next, we need to download a Kali Linux. Kali Linux is a version of a Linux which contains all the tools required for a pen testing. So we don't need to download, install and configure tools. We can simply use a Kali Linux. To download a Kali Linux, go to the kali.org. After that, click on Downloads. As you can see, there are different versions. Kali Linux is developed by Offensive Security Group and they have created different version for a virtualization software such as a VMware, VirtualBox, Hyper-V. This version comes pre-installed with the Kali Linux, so we don't need to install Kali Linux for our VirtualBox. We just need to download this version, run it and we are good to go. To download a copy of a VirtualBox, click here. After that, scroll down. Click here, Kali Linux VirtualBox images, and you can download 64-bit or 32-bit. To download, just click here, or if you want, you can download via torrent also. I have downloaded the Kali Linux VirtualBox image. It has .ova extension. Start your VirtualBox manager. After that, click on File, Import Appliance. Browse to that location. So this is the location where I downloaded the Kali Linux. Select this file. Open, click on continue. After that, click on import. I'll just fast forward this process. You can see here we have successfully imported the Kali Linux. Select that, click on settings. Go to the system. Here you can assign RAM for a Kali Linux. Here you can assign processor core for a Kali Linux. Click on OK. Now select the Kali Linux. After that, click on Start. the username for a Kali Linux is a root. Password is tor, that is TOOR. As you can see, this is our Kali Linux and it came pre-installed, so we didn't need to install anything. Now you can browse all the applications by clicking on applications. Here you can find all the tools for pen testing. Click on this icon to open the terminal. Okay, that's it for this video. As we'll go along in the course, I'll tell you how to use a Kali Linux or some particular tool to understand that exercise. So stay tuned. Thank you.